Hello everybody and welcome to kind of part two of our Dino Alive adventure. If you haven't seen the last video, we recorded the show and it was absolutely amazing. If you haven't seen it, I highly suggest there will be a card taking you there and I'll wait here till you go watch it. You enjoy it? Was it good? Right, back to part two. We have been invited to Dino Alive's warehouse. We're going to see a little bit behind the scenes. I'm really excited about this because this is what I really enjoy, seeing how things work. As you know, after seeing the show, I want to know how the Brachiosaur thing worked. Maybe we won't see that. I don't know. I haven't really been told. Why don't you come with me and see what's going on? Oh, yes. Oh, wow. That's what I was kind of expecting. But to see it all in front of you, my God, wow. Look at these! I saw you in that show! It looks way bigger in person. I think these are what, the Utah Raptors, I think they were. You got the baby stegosaur, giant stegosaurus, and the T-Rex, the biggest and baddest of them all! I'm waiting for one of these to like come to life. Like a jump scare from like Five Nights at Freddy's, except for, I don't know, one day at Dinosaur Warehouse. How did that thing work? Like, I was thinking if there's a dude at the back, you'd have to have a wide stance to get that to work, and you couldn't have one person in each leg. Oh God, I'm now... Post James, tell me what they were. These were the ones that did the dance. So I think you got like the male and the female, a little bit of sexual dimorphism there, and then the Triceratops. And I think this was the one that was the last shown in the show as well. It's like you can't take it all in one shot. You need to turn your head to see it all. It's very strange seeing all the dinosaurs in one place, because I think you only had a max of maybe 5 at a push 6 on the show. Because of course, everyone, you know, there needs to be people inside of them. There would have to be so many dinosaur choreography would be a thing. I think this is the interesting one, because definitely haven't seen this one before, but judging by like the crest on top of it, I'm assuming it's an Allosaurus. Seeing the T-Rex and not feeling intimidated that it might like bite you, although I don't have anything to worry about, the cameraman does, got you last time.
So I was warned that the T-Rex might nibble at you, which I was preparing myself for. However, the cameraman wasn't.
It's like, I'm Steve Irwin. But it'd be great to see like just exactly how these things operate. I assume with like something like the Triceratops, you've got 4 feet, which means you could, you know, you could get like 2 people in there. I mean, you have to, right? Unless it was, you know, moved in some sort of animatronic sort of way. But something like the Utah Raptor, I think it is, or the Pyroraptor, is definitely one person. I've seen the Jurassic World show. When they have something as big as a Brachiosaurus or even the T-Rex, they are not operated by person, I'm pretty sure, like inside. They've got like a moving base and they sort of just walk as if they're gliding a little bit. The commitment and the amount of time that it, you know, it took, especially when I last talked to them on how to get the Brachiosaurus to work, they deserve all sorts of credit, and I can't wait to see like what future plans they've got to take it abroad as well. I quite like looking at the feathered raptors. You've got like feathers put into the actual the claws and stuff at the forearms. A really nice touch on it. I'd assume, you know, even getting the colorings right and how that even works in the costume, I'd imagine it's even hotter in there in comparison to something like a, you know, the stegosaur. Although saying that, I don't know, you've got to be on all fours to operate this, which is gonna be very difficult, I'd imagine.
So once I had a look at the dinosaurs on display, I was able to have a quick chat with the man who had invited me down here in the first place, Kanemura-san. He explained to me what this warehouse was really used for.
So is that where they make the dinosaurs then? So is this where you've worn the Allosaurus before? The show that we went to see?
Yes.
Was, oh!
Dino Aliveの恐竜は今30頭を超えていて、これはごく一部です。
These are your like...I guess the show dinosaurs. These are the ones that look the best, are they? And the rest are sort of like hidden away.
一群ではないね。一群はちょっと、まあ、一群半ぐらいかな。二群まではいかない。
That's smart, not keeping them all in the same place. What goes through your head when you see these creations before you?
自分たちで作っといて、なんかまるで生きてるみたいに見えると、もうなんか まあ、不思議な感覚としか言いようがない、いいなって思うっていうことなのかな。ともかく自分たちで作ってるんですけど、自分たちがそれに酔ってる感じがしますね。毎回驚きがありますね。自分たちで作って自分たちで動かしてるんですけど、毎回こう動いてるのを見るとすごく驚きがあったりします。なのでもっと作りたいっていうふうになります。どんどん作りたい。そうすればするほど、なんだろう、面白くなる。こんな風な生き物だったんじゃないかなっていうのに、どんどんどんどん近づけようとしてるんで、そうするとすごくか、ハマりますね。それになんか、その魅力にハマるみたいな感じで、再現できないことがいっぱいあるんですけども、少しでもこう近づけようってことを一生懸命や
る。I imagine like seeing these in front of you. I know it feels like you're a kid in a toy shop. You must wonder what's going to be the next one. Do you have any ideas or do you have to do storyboard that first and then...Spitball how the show is going to go before you decide on the dinosaur.
これから作るショーに必要な恐竜と、あとは作りたい恐竜っていうもの、その2つで考える。今僕らはまだ鎧竜がいません。多分来年はアンキロサウルスとか、あとパキケファロとか、あの辺がを作ろうとしてまだ持ってないですよ、その種類を。
I mean, you were saying the Brachiosaurus 大変だね。でも Ankylosaur, that must also be quite... I mean, because you see the baby Triceratops, baby Stegosaurus. I'm assuming people have to go on all fours to act those out. Do you know how like an Ankylosaur would work? Because that's quite low to the ground as well. Or would you have it as tall as the Stego or the Ankylosaur? Oh, sorry, Triceratops.
まだ設計の段階なので何とも言えないんですけど、まあ大きいのを作り、8メーターとか、そのぐらいになると思う。全長8メーター。
Ooh, will it be the longest dinosaur that you have here?
このブラキオサウルスが13メーター。
13メーター。
ここにはいないんですけど、肉食だとスコミムス、あれが89メーターのが肉食では一番。
Is there any, I mean, I know I would get crucified if I didn't ask this question, but is there any plans to make a Spinosaurus?
スピノサウルス計画はあります。
Okay.
すごく難しい。Very difficult.
If you make the Spinosaur, will there be a fight with the T-Rex? I know everyone would want to see that.
今4足ですからね。スピノサウルスは4足恐竜になっちゃったから、あんまりそんなに機敏には動けない可能性が高いので、まあでも、バトルはあるとは思いますけどね。
Oh, if they did that, that would be amazing.
多分ティラノの圧勝でしょう、ね。
Your team T-Rex! Oh, wow! Don't tell the Spino fanboys out there. Did you see the most recent Jurassic World Dominion movie?
見ました。
What did you think of the Pyroraptor in there? Because that was a feather dinosaur, and you've made multiple feather dinosaurs. I'd like to get your take on the Universal's take on a feathered dinosaur.
羽のこの種類、この中で、まあ、風切り羽であったり、いろんなものの種類がしっかり作られているので、すごいなと思いましたね。僕らよりもやっぱ羽の種類、このボディの中の羽の種類がすごく多いので、まあ、こうやっぱり CG で作るといかようにでもできるので、すごく羨ましいところがありますね。なかなか実体のあるもので作るとなると、羽って作るのがすごく難しいんですよ。うちの羽は割と種類が少ないんですけど、まあその辺が見てて、すごい参考にはなりましたけど、あれを再現するの大変だなと思いました。あと動きがすごいですよね、映画の中で。まああそこまでは動けないんじゃないかなっていう印象はありますけどね。
Have you piloted every dinosaur here? Is that sort of like the sort of christening process that you have to get this, you give them the seal of approval and then they can move forward to the regular people?
僕も作ってますので、全部。
It's like John Hammond, you know, the birth of being there for the birth of every dinosaur. It's controlled every one of these dinosaurs. Kanemaru-san was now going to show me a bit of the dinosaurs rehearsing some of their performances. In order to do that, however, we had to move out of the soundstage and into a back room while they set up. It's here where I wanted to get to know a little bit more about the man behind these amazing projects. And just maybe I could get some top secret trade tips he would be willing to share. I was curious to see if the show had been compared a lot with the Jurassic franchise, and if so,How does he feel about that?
そうですね。5、6年前は割と比較されることがありましたけど、今はあまり比較されないですね。ディノアライブっていうのが割と日本ではみんな知ってるので、そういうものがあるっていうのを恐竜のファンは ある程度も知ったので、ユニバーサルとは別だってことはよく知っていると。で、いっぱいショーやりましたからね。リアルな恐竜見たかったらディノアライブだね。そんな風になってますよ。
And then of course I had to ask him the question of if you had unlimited budget, what kind of show would he make?
ね、本当にでっかい会場で、もう本当に100頭以上の恐竜が体験できるような、本当にもうその群れに、もうトリケラトプスとか10頭、20頭の群れが目の前を通り過ぎてきた。僕らワンハンドデッドダイナソーって言ってるんですけど、そのぐらいの体験ができる。
And it's at this point we were called back to the soundstage to experience the dinosaur rehearsal show. It's one thing sitting down and experiencing it in a theater, but it's another when it's right in front of you.
Oh, wow.
I don't like that it's looking at me and slowly coming closer. So this is what it feels like to be prey. I don't know if I like dinosaurs anymore. Guai. That wasn't in the script. I don't know how you keep your ground. I now know I wouldn't last in the primordial forest, that's for sure. God, the Triceratops is even bigger than the T-Rex, wow. I don't even know what to say. I'm speechless. Oh wow. When the T-Rex does his roar, he gets a lot taller. Good boy. Or girl, I don't know. I don't like it! Yeah!
Charmed by a T-Rex. It was great. I can see why you love this business.
Having seen the dinosaurs again, I wanted to see if I could get a little bit more insight into how the dinosaurs actually worked. As much as I tried, Kanamura-san would not give up the secrets to how these dinosaurs work. But maybe next time, though, I'll be able to operate one of them. Fingers crossed.
Do you assign certain people to specific dinosaurs and then that's all they do? Or do they mix and match?
専属の人もいますし、いろんな恐竜を操縦することができる人もいます。それはもうパイロットが選ぶって。
So do they come to you asking to be like the T-Rex or the Allosaur then?
そうですね。
Does each dinosaur have multiple pilots then?
そうですね。うちは今パイロットだけで50人以上います。メインパイロット、サブパイロット、結構交代したりです、ね、ローテーションです。なので、一つの恐竜に今4、5人はいるんです。それを操縦できる人、動かせる人。
I mean, as you can see, posters of the Dino Safari as well, which is a different one. I'm assuming, is it a simpler process to choose the actors that aren't going to be in the dinosaur costumes then?
そうですね。確かに。中に入る人は、オーディションがまずありますから。オーディションがあって、一次選考みたいなって。で、次に、要は、実技トレーニングみたいなのって、その中で優秀な人とか、感じの仕組みになってます。
It sounds like a Gundam in a way, like how they're pilots and they have to choose the sort.
そうなっちゃいますね。恐竜を動かしたい人って結構いるんですよ。だから期待が足りないです。
When you're picking pilots, what is it that you look for? Is there an X factor when it comes to them? Because I'm assuming they would have to really enjoy dinosaurs.
これはね、センスなんですけど、生き物とか人間じゃない生き物になりきれる、それはもともと持ってる人たちがいますね。要はそのセンスとして、いわゆるその人間が人間を演じてるわけじゃなくて、人間が恐竜を演じてますから、そこのこう入り込める人っていうのがやっぱ向いてますね。もう本当にその恐竜にとか別な生き物になりきれるみたいな人っていうのはちょっといますね。そういう人がすごくいいパイロットになる。すごい、僕らエースパイロットって言ってるんですけど、本当にトップレベルのパイロットはやっぱすごいです。自分たち、僕らが見てても、そんな風に動けるんだとか、そんな風に動くんだっていうのがどんどん出てくるので、マニュアルはあるんですよ。操縦マニュアルみたいなのを僕ら作ってるんですけど、そのマニュアル以外の動きがいっぱい出てくる。
The longer I talked to Kanemura-san, the more I understood that it isn't just him that shares this passion for the dinosaurs, but the entire team. From the actors to the pilots, each of them sharing such a vital role in this performance.
So that's where it goes above, you know, just playing the dinosaur. They have to really get into the mind of it and even, you know, like improvise it as well then. So maybe in another life I could have been a pilot then. Do you see yourself ever retiring from this profession, or will you be doing it till the day you die? That's the issue, because you never get there, because as soon as you've done one thing, you're on to the next. So it's a curse in a way.
So
next year is the big one then?
そうですね。あの、一つの節目ですよね。僕らのターニングポイントみたいなもうそういうものになって、やっとこう、要はパークができるってことになりますね。パークにすごい近づきます。
Are we gonna see some rumblings of a park coming then, are we?
まだその、パーク自体はだいぶ先でしょうけど、その、いわゆるスピーシーズでしたっけ、その種類っていうのが揃うので、いつでもね、
Well, your enthusiasm for dinosaurs is infectious, and I feel like everybody that I come across, paleontologists, entertainers, CEOs that are in the dinosaur field always have this, it's almost like a zest for life. And I think if you're in the you're in the field of dinosaurs, you kind of have to have that. So I just want to say thank you so much for allowing me to not only have like a private part one, which was the tour or the show, but also a mini rehearsal as well. So I want to thank you so much for that. I can't wait till next year and we'll see all the new dinosaurs and maybe hints towards a park at some point. But itsumo tanoshimi na. ありがとうございます。So, there you have it. A little bit of behind the scenes look at Dino Alive. I mean, not just Dino Alive. They had the Dino Safari, and we sort of found out all the sort of the cool backstage sort of things. And of course, seeing Kanemura-san again is always a pleasure. His enthusiasm for the dinosaurs and pretty much everybody who's on this project as well. If you've enjoyed this video, leave a like, and until next time, I'll see you cuties later. Bye-bye.